Today my class is on resolution of a vector into two rectangular components. Resolution of a vector into two rectangular components. Resolution of vector into two rectangular components. What are rectangular components? To know the resolution of vector into rectangular components, we have to learn representation of a vector. Suppose a vector, this is vector A bar. So this point O, this point is P. This A bar is represented by OP bar. So OP bar is equal to A bar. The vector A bar is represented by the line OP. The length of this line is the magnitude of vector A bar is proportional to length of this line. The point O is known as initial point. Initial point for our tail, for our origin. Initial O, this is the starting point of the vector. This is known as initial point or tail or origin. This point P is known as head or tip or terminus. Head or tip or terminus of the vector. This arrow mark represents the direction of vector. This length represents the magnitude of the vector. So this is the representation of vector. Starting point is known as initial point or tail or origin. End point, this end point is known as head or tip or terminus. So now the resolution of vector. Suppose a vector, this is x axis, this is y axis. Suppose a vector, this is a vector A bar, makes an angle theta with x axis. We know the I cap is unit vector along x axis, j cap is unit vector along j cap, along y axis. J cap is unit vector along y axis. Here, unit vectors, what are unit vectors? A unit vector represents the direction. So, what is the magnitude of a unit vector? Modulus of I cap is 1. Modulus of j cap is 1, modulus of k cap is 1. Here I cap is unit vector along x axis, j cap is unit vector along y axis, k cap is unit vector along z axis. But the magnitude of I cap or j cap or k cap is equal to 1. So a vector whose magnitude is 1 is known as unit vector. What is the use of unit vector? Unit vector gives the direction. So this vector A bar makes an angle theta with x axis. Here the two points, this is AX, one line along the x axis. Second, this is AY. Second line along the y-axis. AX is known as component of vector along x-axis. AY is known as component of vector along y-axis. So how to find the values of AX and AY? So here AX into I cap is AX into I cap is vector component of the vector along x axis. AY into j cap is the vector component of A bar along y axis. How to calculate AX and AY? Simple thing. Here this AY is displaced perpendicular to its length in such a way like this. AY. The tail of AY coincides with the head of AX. This forms a triangle. This is a A bar. This is AX bar. This is AY bar. So this gives A bar is equal to AX bar plus AY bar. AX bar plus AY bar. A bar is equal to AX bar plus AY bar. So according to Pythagoras theorem, this angle is theta, this is A, this is AY, this is AX, AY, AX. What is the value of sine theta? Sine theta is equal to AY by A. Sine theta is equal to AY by A. AY can be expressed as A sine theta. Now from the diagram, A cos theta is equal to cos theta adjacent by hypotenuse. AX by A. AX is equal to A cos theta. AY is equal to A sin theta, AX is equal to A cos theta. So here, this is A bar, this is AX, this is AY, AY bar, AX bar. AY, AX bar is nothing but AX bar is equal to AX into I cap. What is AY bar? AY bar is nothing but AY into J cap. So this is the angle theta. So A bar can be expressed as AX I cap plus AY J cap. A bar can be expressed as AX I cap plus AY J cap. A bar is equal to A cos theta I cap plus A sin theta J cap. So this is the representation of vector into two rectangular components.